Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Thursday morning. It's Stephen Whiteside here from the uptrend.com with today's very quick market update on the North American markets. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures in the U.S. are ever so slightly above fair value. Canadian futures are flat, while commodities are lower in the pre-market on Thursday morning. Now, yesterday we saw a spike in the fear index. This time we closed above the upper channel line right at the high of the day. Since the start of 2019, we've had three previous spikes in the fear index, which quickly dissipated in just a couple of days, and so we'll keep an eye on this one. This one is the only one to generate a change in momentum, and that could be a key to telling us that this is different this time, but we'll just have to wait and see. Now, the Dow Diamonds have been up at resistance for a couple of weeks, have not been able to make new highs. While we've seen new highs in the Spider ETF and the Qs, the Spider, we were looking to see if we could move up to 296.88. That was the top of our projected trading range. And yesterday we saw a pullback in the Spider ETF, not enough to give us a sell signal. We need a close on Thursday below 290.70. And then for the Qs, a similar chart pattern yesterday, and we're looking for a close below 187.97. Now, what broke yesterday? Well, consumer discretionary stocks are back on sell signals, as are the retail stocks. And what was already broken? Well, we saw a big sell-off yesterday in energy stocks and the transports. The transports making a new low for this move on Thursday. Now, Apple Computer came into yesterday on a sell signal, generated a new sell signal, which of course you would have waved off if you checked the pre-market numbers. We ran up, hit the 1250 level. We traded higher than that intraday before pulling back at the close. And so if you had an order in up there at 212.50, that got filled yesterday. The remainder of your position, you would get kicked out on Thursday with a close below 202.56. Doesn't look like we're going to get that on Thursday. And of course, that lower channel line is going to move higher daily. Next up, let's take a look at the Canadian market. And the TSX generated a sell signal on Wednesday, while the TSX 60 has a little more work to do on the downside. And so if you have a mutual fund or an ETF that tracks the TSX, it is back on a short-term sell signal. If you have a mutual fund or ETF that tracks the TSX 60, we have a little more work to do. Now, you can see more aggressive selling in mid-cap stocks on Wednesday, a lot more aggressive selling in small caps, while micro caps did not come into focus on Wednesday. They were down on the day, but we still have not taken out the recent low just yet. Now, of course, just like in the U.S., energy stocks got clobbered yesterday, and anything mining related got clobbered on Wednesday. So you're looking at the base metals down over 3%. We've got gold stocks down nearly 1.5%, and global mining stocks down just over 2% on the day. Now, the financials and the banking sector both held up fairly well yesterday. They were down on the day, but ever so slightly. And of course, the first thing I look for when I'm looking at a chart, yes, we had a pullback. Did we take out the previous day's low? And we certainly did not. So still holding up above the March highs, and that is still bullish for the financials and the banking sector. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Next time you'll hear my voice is on Friday morning. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.